Relationship management.
Dale Carnegie is an extension of my training staff, and I have been fortunate enough to have a relationship with them that reflects that.
It's proven, it's been out there for a long time, and it ties directly into what Barron's Lumber is trying to achieve.
Dale Carnegie, ignite performance.
When I married my husband, I married the mountain.
If there's white stuff on the ground, we're there.
I love skiing and hanging out with my friends.
The snowboarding here is amazing. And the snow conditions and staff are awesome.
I can't think of many other places or activities we share as a family.
Bring your family to the mountain. Round Top Mountain Resort, Liberty Mountain Resort, or Whitetail Resort. Get details about special learn to ski and snowboard packages at takeasnowday.com.
Good morning, America. Breaking overnight, the WikiLeaks founder speaks out, saying the Russian government had no role in that election hacking. As President-elect Trump takes on the intelligence community, trumpets two big victories. Going against his own party, calls out Ford, which is 16 days until the inauguration.
Arctic blast, snow and ice slamming the west, dangerous conditions shutting down I-70 overnight. Now a bitter blast moving across the country for millions, and the new dramatic snowy rescue caught on camera.
A captivating new interview from one of the biggest crimes of the century. One of the Menendez brothers now speaks out for the first time in 20 years from behind bars.
I am the kid that did kill his parents.
The Beverly Hills brothers who murdered their mom and dad nearly three decades ago now reveal the side of their story you haven't heard before. An exclusive first look only on GMA this morning.
And baby, oh baby, Janet Jackson's huge news becoming a first-time mom at 50. What she's revealing about her new son as Rhythm Nation celebrates this morning.
Live in Times Square, this is GMA with Robin Roberts, George Stephanopoulos, and Michael Strahan.
Can't go wrong listening to a little Janet Jackson. Oh, it's a lot for her and her husband to celebrate this morning. Welcome, baby boy, Issa. Her rep says everyone is doing well.
Such great news. We'll have a lot more on that coming up. Big day in Congress yesterday. Everyone got sworn in. And check out this moment. Roger Marshall, congressman from Kansas, getting sworn in. That's his son right there in the middle, jostling. Well, he's dabbing there, jostling with Speaker Paul Ryan. We're going to tell you what happened, the story behind the story coming up. Right. But first, the Trump transition, inauguration 16 days away. Plenty of action already. Overnight, another tweet from the president-elect taunting the intelligence community about those claims of Russian hacking the election, as WikiLeaks founder Julian Assange denies his leaks came from Russia. Our chief investigative correspondent, Brian Ross, is here with the story. Good morning, Brian.
Well, good morning, George. Overnight, Donald Trump claimed via Twitter that the long-awaited report on who hacked the Democratic Party had been delayed and will now be delivered to him this Friday.
In his Twitter post, Trump continued to cast doubt about the role of the Russians. Perhaps more time needed to build a case, he wrote. Very strange. And now Trump is being joined in his skepticism by the man who's been hiding out in this embassy in London for the last 4 years. Julian Assange, the founder of WikiLeaks, appearing on Fox with Sean Hannity.
We can say, we have said repeatedly over the last 2 months that our source is not the Russian government and it is not a state party.
But the head of the CIA says, in effect, Assange doesn't know what he's talking about, that it was the Russians.
This report is going to include what it is that we know about what happened, what was collected, what was disclosed, and what the purpose and intent of that effort was.
And officials say it's equally clear the embarrassing Democratic Party emails were delivered to WikiLeaks by a middleman for the Russians, or what spies call a cutout.
There's no way that Assange would have any idea who was behind dropping this information off. The Russian intelligence services are clearly capable of hiding their tracks, of using a cutout to provide this information to WikiLeaks.
So now the president-elect finds himself strange bedfellows with Russian President Putin and WikiLeaks founder Assange, who delivers a message much like that of Trump's transition team.
They're trying to delegitimize the Trump administration as it goes into the White House.
Whether Assange is a knowing participant or what the Russians call a useful idiot, that's hard to tell. But nonetheless, the Russians were very much behind the hacking and the dumping of this information.
And officials tell ABC News this morning both President Obama and the president-elect will receive their copies of the classified report with a briefing on Friday,
George. But there do seem to be some cross wires here. It appears that the president-elect and members of his team were under the impression that this briefing was coming early in the week, probably yesterday.
That's right, but intelligence officials tell us this morning there was never a plan to give it any time before Friday. Friday was always the date. There was no delay. They're not sure what he's talking about, whether it's a simple miscommunication or part of the growing sense of mistrust that Mr. Trump is fueling with his Twitter messages.
Okay, Brian Ross, thanks very much.
All right, George, and President-elect Trump also putting the pressure on Congress, going against members of his own party for trying to strip power from the Congressional Ethics Office. House Republicans quickly reversing course on Tuesday. Our congressional correspondent, Mary Bruce, has more, joins us from Washington. Good morning, Mary.
Good morning, Robin. Yeah, it is a new Republican era here on Capitol Hill, nearly a decade in the making. And this morning, Republicans are trying to move on after their first day was overshadowed by stumbles and a clash with the president-elect. This morning, Donald Trump showing he can get Republicans to fall in line. Just a day after Republicans voted to eliminate an independent ethics body, the measure was scrapped.
And are you concerned about the message that this is sending on the first day of the new Congress?
Well, I think, you know, a good message is being sent here, which is, you know, Republican leadership and membership alike said this is a problem, we need to change it, and we just did.
Republicans buckling under pressure from constituents, party leaders, and the president-elect. Trump tweeting, with all that Congress has to work on, do they really have to make the weakening of the independent ethics watchdog, as unfair as it may be, their number one act and priority? Focus on tax reform, health care, and so many other things of far greater importance. ABC News learning Trump called House Speaker Paul Ryan right after the ethics changes were ditched. Republicans now trying to regroup, taking the first step towards repealing Obamacare.
This is a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity. This is the kind of thing that most of us only dreamed about. I know because I used to dream about this a lot.
But the Democrats, with their new leader in the Senate who's friendly with Trump, are vowing to keep Republicans in check.
It is not our job to be a rubber stamp. It's our job to do what's best for the American people, the middle class, and those struggling to get there.
Now, as the Capitol prepares for the inauguration just 16 days away, we've learned that all of the former living presidents, except George H.W. Bush, will be here for the big day. Even Hillary Clinton will be on that stage, putting her face-to-face with Donald Trump for the first time since the campaign and in front of an audience of millions. Robin.
That will be quite a moment, Mary. And also that moment that George was alluding to earlier with Paul Ryan. He got a little bit of a lesson in dabbing.
Yeah, that's the real debate up here this morning, is over dabbing. House Speaker Paul Ryan was swearing in a new Kansas representative, the whole family there posing for pictures, when suddenly the congressman's son showed off that popular dance move. The speaker seemed to have absolutely no idea what was going on. He even asked the boy if he needed to sneeze. The speaker later on Twitter saying he had just sworn in nearly 300 new members, but that he still has no idea what dabbing is. And in case you guys are wondering, that congressman's son this morning, he is so grounded.
Yeah. Yeah, the tweet just came out, John Cole as well, because, you know, the kid was being kind of a jerk.
Yeah, but, you know, he also had it wrong, isn't it? Two hands? I mean, you know, I don't know. I mean, and Paul Ryan was entirely clueless, which surprised me because Cam Newton did this. Paul Ryan's a big football fan. I don't know, you know?
Yeah. Okay, well, stand by. We want to move on now, though, to the president-elect taking another victory lap after calling out Ford for a plan to build a $1.6 billion plant in Mexico yesterday. Company called Trump to tell them they are scrapping the plan, adding hundreds of jobs in the U.S. Our business correspondent Rebecca Jarvis spoke to Ford CEO about the decision. Good morning, Rebecca.
Good morning, George. And as you say, that plant in Mexico was a focus of Donald Trump's criticism on the campaign trail. Now Ford says it is scrapping those plans, instead moving production of the new Ford Focus to a pre-existing plant in Mexico. And rather than adding 2,800 jobs in Mexico, the company will create 700 jobs here in the U.S. for new electric and self-driving cars. I asked Ford CEO Mark Fields what role the president-elect played in that decision.
Did you feel any pressure from president-elect Donald Trump to make this decision?
We look at a lot of different factors, and one of the factors that we're looking at is our view is that there's going to be a more positive business environment for U.S. manufacturing under president-elect Trump. His pro-growth policies that he's been talking about, we think, could be very beneficial. And this is a vote of confidence that we feel he can deliver on those things.
And ahead of the announcement, Fields tells me he shared the news in a phone call with both President-elect Donald Trump and Vice President-elect Mike Pence. Fields tells me it was a positive conversation, George.
Okay, Rebecca, thanks. So, John Carl, we got two instances yesterday, both with the Congress on that ethics thing and this Ford announcement, where you see big institutions unwilling to cross him.
Yeah, no doubt. And I'll tell you, the thing with Congress is very interesting, George, because Donald Trump is more popular in the districts of many of these Republican congressmen than the congressmen themselves. So he has the ability to really put some pressure on them. In this case, he was backing up Republican leadership. Paul Ryan and Kevin McCarthy, the Republican leaders, wanted this reversed. Donald Trump was on their side. What happens the next time when he's against leadership? He's got a real power to move. The Ford thing, by the way, 700 jobs in an economy that has to create 200,000 a month essentially to stay even, isn't a big thing in a macro, but very powerful, once again, symbolic.
And one of these places where he may be courting trouble is this taunting of the intelligence community at odds with Senate Republicans on whether Russia was behind this. That's going to come to head this week.
Yeah, absolutely. This briefing, and the intelligence community, you can tell, they are irritated. Intelligence leaders are irritated to see Trump questioning them in public. He's even used intelligence in quotes. And they say this briefing was absolutely scheduled for Friday. But here's the question. What happens at some point during the Trump presidency when Trump is called into the Situation Room and has to make a decision on an act of war based on intelligence presented to him by the very people that he is right now questioning?
Well, he's certainly willing to press them right now. We see a big showdown coming as well, and it's going to play out on Capitol Hill today. You have President Obama going down to speak to Democrats about the Obamacare repeal. Vice President-elect Pence going to speak to Republicans. This is going to be the big battle of the next 2 months.
This is the first big battle, and the Republican strategy here is essentially to say we are going to repeal Obamacare, not all of it, most of it, and then make it effective in about 3 years. So it'll give them about 3 years' time to figure out how to replace it. So the first step is not an immediate step. I mean, there'll be an immediate battle, an immediate vote, but Obamacare will not be repealed until towards the end of Trump's term.
Well, the question is, though, what happens to the health insurance community intervening years, 16 days away from the inauguration? Yeah. The acceptances are starting to come in.
Yeah, and what a moment that's going to be to see Trump there with the other former presidents, President Bush, President Clinton, of course, Hillary up there. But he's not only getting sworn in as president, he's getting welcomed into the most exclusive club of all, the Club of Presidents.
And that's really a sign there to see all the former presidents there with them. You're right. Well, let's talk about the weather now. That Arctic blast that is moving in, snow and ice shutting down an interstate in Colorado. What's going on here, Ginger?
That's right, I-70 in Colorado. We have the pictures right here of all that traffic right around Loveland Pass, this video's from. That was happening, and we've got more storms on the way, so we needed to warn you of this, because look what's happening in Sacramento, California. Trees down, so much rain in the last couple of days, and so much yet to come in the next week or so, that we have these winter storm warnings and advisories that stretch now all the way to Illinois. The winter weather alerts, the wind chill warnings, are actually for 40 to 45 below zero in parts of North and South Dakota this morning. These are numbers for Thursday morning. It'll feel like 10 below in Chicago, 2 below Detroit, 9 for Boston. So the cold air just keeps sweeping to the east. And with it, it'll squeeze some moisture out. You see this, up to 6 inches in the Bay Area, up to 4 feet of mountain snow, which they're very happy with. But look at this picture. This is out of Utah. Remember that place where this happened just a couple of days ago?
It happened again
at the same resort. We've got that young man dangling from the ski lift by his backpack. Fortunately, they were able to get two people up there, and they were able to get him off, and he's okay.
Yeah, glad he's okay.
Much as it's great to have that snow, you got to be safe on the ski lift.
Sure do.
Okay, Ginger, thank you. We're going to move overseas now for the latest on that deadly New Year's Eve terror attack in Turkey. Turkish authorities are hunting for the killer. There he is right there. That's the suspect, and they detained 5 more people overnight. ABC's Alex Marquardt is on the scene in Istanbul, takes us inside the nightclub where the attack went down. Good morning, Alex.
And that's right, we are inside the Reina nightclub, once so popular with tourists and Turkey's elite, now eerie and empty. You can see here, little has changed since that horrible night. The bar here still piled high with bottles and glasses. Back there on the mirror, Happy New Year is written. Instead, this New Year started in a way no one could ever have imagined.
Bullet holes, blood stains on the wall, the remnants of a celebration that turned into a nightmare. This morning, we walked through the club, unnervingly frozen in the moment of the massacre that took 39 lives.
As the gunman made his way through the club, the guests were so desperate to flee that around 50 of them jumped here into the frigid waters of the Bosphorus to escape.
And you're right there.
Ali Unal is the manager of Reyna. Right, he showed us where he was that night, at the entrance when the gunmen stormed in. As bullets land around him, you can see Unal falling. The gunman ran past and shot the man next to him.
Did you think that you would survive this attack?
I survived, he tells me, but I'm not happy to be alive. The trauma clearly so fresh and painful. This morning, Turkish authorities say they know the shooter's name and have his fingerprints from the gun he left behind. They've tracked his movements and arrested dozens said to be connected to the attack, including the man's wife, who said she had no idea he was affiliated with ISIS. But for now, the killer remains on the run.
With this manhunt now in its fourth day, the worry is the shooter could have gotten out of Istanbul and could be anywhere in the country, even farther. He is suspected of having fought with ISIS in Syria, and the fear now is that he could slip back across that border into ISIS-held territory. George.
Okay, Alex, thanks very much.
On now to a health alert here at home. If you haven't gotten your flu shot yet, the CDC has a message. Do it now. Some areas are already seeing a spike in cases, and health officials say for the rest of us, it's just a matter of time. Oh, our chief health medical editor, Dr. Richard Besser, is here now. And this is not unusual to see a spike in some states about this time of year.
That's right. You know, the only thing that's predictable about flu is that we will have a flu season. There will be an epidemic. Usually the peak is between January and March, and we're seeing it in four states right now. So Arizona, Georgia, Alabama, Oklahoma are having big flu spikes, New York City and Puerto Rico as well.
You're one of those that you feel the sooner the better. But if you haven't gotten it yet, is it too late?
Yeah, I mean, I recommend between Halloween and Thanksgiving that's a great time to get the flu vaccine. But there is a suggestion that the closer you are to the peak, actually the better protection you're going to have. It takes about 2 weeks for the vaccine to work. The good news is that the strain of flu that's traveling around the country is in this year's vaccine.
Okay, and how about that nasal spray option? We're hearing it's not a good one, but a lot of people don't want to get the shot, doesn't matter what age you are.
I know. As a pediatrician, it really bums me out, because I love being able to say to parents, you know, flu vaccine, but it's not going to be a shot. No nasal flu this year, because last year the vaccine didn't work. Oof. Everyone needs to get a shot. High dose vaccine for people 65 and older hopefully will give more protection. There's a micro needle. It's injected just into the skin. You won't feel it for people of all ages who don't like shots. And then there is new recommendation for people with egg allergies so they can get vaccinated too.
Can I ask one more question?
Yeah.
So if you got the flu shot early, should you get a booster?
Or no, you shouldn't get a booster. You know, it's this gamble of do you wait it out or not? Mm. Between Halloween and Thanksgiving, you know, gives you the best assurity, but it's not too late to get it.
But there's so many people who say they get sick when they get the shot.
I know. Because there's so many viruses going around right now, you could get one of those too.
Right.
The vaccine doesn't make you sick.
All right, got it. Now Amy has morning's other top story, starting with a protest over one of President-elect Trump's nominees.
That's right. Good morning, guys. And we are getting our first look at protesters being handcuffed and arrested at the Alabama office of Senator Jeff Sessions, President-elect Trump's nominee for attorney general. The NAACP led the sit-in protest. The president of the civil rights group was among six people taken into custody. They want Sessions to be removed from consideration. The group has questioned his record on civil rights and voting rights. Well, a school officer in North Carolina caught on video slamming a female high school student to the floor has now been placed on administrative leave. Witnesses say the girl was trying to break up a fight involving her sister. The teen's mother told reporters the girl suffered a concussion. Well, the FDA says it will now investigate the danger of e-cigarette batteries after dozens of fires and explosions in recent weeks. Some victims suffered serious injuries. The FDA began regulating e-cigarettes just last year. And finally, it's a tough day on the ice for a polar bear filming a commercial for a car dealership in Minnesota. Take a look. The polar bear mascot was trying to pose for the camera there. He couldn't keep his balance. He fell over and over and over again. And just when you thought he was going to hold it all together, there he is. Well, down goes White Bear Mitsubishi. Yeah. They posted the outtakes online. I thought a pun here would, you know, I don't know. I thought it would be polarizing. Oh, wow. Is that unbearable? Sorry.
No! Are there more? Do you have more bear?
No, there's so many bear puns. I mean, it's impossible that he did.
Oh, got another one in there. You are masterful.
Oh, goodness.
Another check, Ginger.
Yeah, and, you know, we love you, everybody in the Southeast, but you don't do great with snow, and everybody's starting to talk about this. Thursday through Saturday, the timing as that cold air comes in and a couple of lows slide across, there's a potential for a wintry mix or snow. Watch your local ABC stations for the very latest on that. Your local weather in 30 seconds, though. First, the wind chill forecast brought to you by Burlington.
We always come to Burlington to buy our coats.
And we also come to give them back.
To help those in need. Can't beat the brands, the styles, and when we donate a coat at Burlington, we get 10% off our entire purchase. Burlington's been collecting coats for 10 years.
Bring in your coats!
Look who's lining up to donate coats and share the warmth. For 10 years, together we've helped keep America warm. And now this year...
It's getting a little cold outside, so I wanted to remind everybody to go and donate a coat.
So go to any Burlington store to donate a coat and be part of our annual coat drive.
Well, today's going to be the warmest day out of the next 10 easily and a good day to get out. The morning fog will burn off. Temperatures today will rise into the low 50s with a little bit of a breeze. Delays likely on Friday, as there is a weather system that is going to come right through our area, producing some snow across the area, enough so that it's going to coat the ground. And there may even be a little bit more coming our way late Saturday to our south and east, but a cold weekend for sure with highs under freezing right through Monday of next week.
Coming up, the brand new interview from one of the biggest crimes of the century, Lyle Menendez, speaking out for the first time in 20 years about the murder of his parents in Beverly Hills. You'll see it only here on GMA.
And there are new concerns about fumes on planes after seven American Airlines flight attendants sent to the hospital. We'll have more on that coming up in our Big Board.
Began with a boy. His name was Ethan. We spent every day together.
Oh, whoa! Sorry, that was Bailey.
You should teach your dog some manners.
My time with Ethan was coming to an end.
Good boy, Bailey.
And then it happened. I was back again and again. How was I going to get back to him?
On January 27th.
Good job.
Sometimes the journey home.
Have we met before?
Is an adventure you never forget. A Dog's Purpose. Rated PG.
I use artificial tears often, but when my eye doctor said I had a disease, that got my attention.
You have a disease called chronic dry eye, caused by reduced tear production due to inflammation. You need Restasis, cyclosporine ophthalmic emulsion. Artificial tears give temporary relief, but with continued use, one drop in each eye twice a day, every day. Restasis helps increase your eye's natural ability to produce tears, which may be reduced by inflammation due to chronic dry eye. Restasis did not increase tear production in patients using anti-inflammatory eye drops or tear duct plugs. To help avoid eye injury and contamination, do not touch the vial tip to your eye or other surfaces. Contact lenses should not be worn within 15 minutes of using Restasis. The most common side effect is a temporary burning sensation.
Call your eye doctor to get screened and ask about Restasis.
It's all-you-can-eat pancake time at IHOP. So put on your stretchy pants and find out how many delicious, world-famous buttermilk pancakes you can eat. But you better hurry, because all-you-can-eat pancakes ends February 12th. IHOP. Eat up every moment.
From ABC 7 News, this is a Good Morning Washington update.
Good morning, Washington. I'm Melanie Hastings. Here's a check of your top stories. A woman is in police custody after she was caught on surveillance cameras using the credit card of a missing man in Bethesda. Police confirmed that woman turned herself in after using John Donahoe's card. She's been charged with credit card fraud, but police don't know how she got the card. Donahoe was first reported missing December the 14th. Dueling meetings on Capitol Hill today about the Affordable Care Act. In about an hour and a half, President Obama will meet with Democratic leaders to discuss ways to save Obamacare. And at the same time, Vice President-elect Mike Pence is set to meet with House Republicans to discuss plans for repealing it. And a live look at Connecticut Avenue, where a downed tree is blocking traffic in both directions at Grand Prix Road. We'll be checking in on the traffic impact with Angela Foster in 2 minutes.
Everything nature's promise is so wholesome.
It doesn't take the whole paycheck.
Giant's exclusive Nature's Promise. Eat well for less. My Giant. Now save this week with 25% off Nature's Promise poultry, seafood, or artisan breads.
Beautiful home decor begins here. Belfort Furniture is expanding. Stop in and celebrate the new year with a fresh new look and save on the styles you love. Our remodeling event is on. To make room for our construction crews, we've drastically reduced floor samples, one-of-a-kinds, and special buys. Save on thousands of pieces. Plus, take an extra 15% off all blue tag items. The latest styles, the very best prices. Beautiful rooms begin at Belfort Furniture, Washington's premier furniture mall.
The Florida Keys is home to a protected 2,900 square mile National Marine Sanctuary, an abundance of wrecks, and thousands of different species of marine life. Learn to dive in the Florida Keys, and you'll open the door to an entirely new world. Visit flakeys.com.
Boneless chicken.
Yeah, we love low prices. No bones about it.
Thousands of blue tags, thousands of low prices. My Giant. Now save this week on Lean Cuisine frozen entrees, 5 for $10.
Today's going to be one of those days where you have to get out and enjoy yourself. A little breezy, but temperatures today will top out in the lower 50s with sunshine. Then we'll be tracking this next event that comes in very late Thursday night, early part of the day on Friday. And it's looking like we're going to get a light coating of snow where traffic will be impacted. Delays looking more likely now for early Friday morning and maybe even through Friday midday. Your extended forecast, here we go. Temperatures today in the mid-50s, starting tomorrow in the 30s, right through Monday of next week.
Veronica, traffic is tied up in Aspen Hill, Maryland. Car into a tree, southbound Connecticut Avenue. We are shut down both directions on your approach to Georgia Avenue. And of course, you'll need to plan for a detour as traffic is being released from the area. You will have to work around the incident. Still seeing some patchy fog in the area around the Capitol Beltway, especially crash on 95 in Maryland, tying us up 2 lanes blocked as you get close to the Capitol Beltway.
How can an elephant go undercover to ensure great customer service? Well, by observing undetected. I'm happy to see top-notch service every day. And when I'm happy...
More care, less cost. Discover the elephant difference at elephant.com.
The Fur Salon at Saks Jandel is going out in style. Truckloads of furs, 50 to 60% off, plus take an additional 20% off. Top designer furs, bottomed out prices. At Saks Jandel, Wisconsin Avenue, Chevy Chase. Don't miss it.
97.1 Wash FM, Washington's variety of the 80s, 90s, and today. Start your workday commercial-free at 8 o'clock. 97.1 Wash FM.
I like the Greek yogurt on the left, and I like the Greek yogurt on the right. But with the one on the right, I can afford a vacation with my girl. Hey, Venus, catch! Throw it back! Sorry, never mind.
You'll like them both, but love our price. Aldi, simply smarter shopping.